Hello and welcome to a new video. My name is Herbert Juster and today we discuss the Big 6 polymer filament materials for desktop 3D printing. Okay, let us get started with a first definition. So filaments are needed for the so-called fused filament fabrication, so the FFF, or fused deposition modeling, FDM, or more simply put, the desktop printing. And the filament is heated up and placed over each other. So layer by layer, you turn a two-dimensional structure into a three-dimensional structure. And this is also good shown here in this video. So the desktop printing is used complementary to injection molding, and also when you have flow quantities, a high need of customization. Okay, give you a brief overview. So we will discuss the Big 6 filament materials and then also mention some high performance polymers which are suitable for the filament printing. So the first one of the Big 6 is polylactic acid, so PLA. It's a printing material and also it's lower printing temperature, PS. And there's also less warping involved compared to ABS. And it's the smell of the filament during processing is a minimum, so there are no bad smells. You can have lots of different colors and styles, and it's also biodegradable thermoplastic. So when to use it now the best? PLA is a all-rounder. You can use it for several applications, however, have to take care it's brittle. So all applications, lots of bend, twisting, or repeat dropping is involved, is difficult to do with PLA. Avoid high temperature applications, so above 60 degrees C. What are the pros? So easy to print. You have lots of colors and styles, and it's also biodegradable. What are some cons? So it's a brittle material, has low mechanical and thermal properties. Here are also shown some selected material properties of the PLA. Second material of the Big 6 is acrylonitrile butadiene styrene, for short ABS. It's the second most popular filament, and ABS is slightly superior to PLA. However, downside is it's harder to print. ABS has a high durability. It's withstanding also higher temperatures. Needs also a higher printing temperature. And already mentioned before, it has a tendency to warp during cooling. There are smells hence, so it's always recommended to use heated bed and well ventilated space. So when to use it now best? Every time you have you need tough applications together where you have higher stresses and temperatures involved, and also for example applications which are dropped or also heated. So what are the pros? The high durability, the high strength, and also the high temperature resistance. The cons are the involvement of high temperature printing nozzle and also this risk of warping during cooling, and perhaps always well ventilated spaces are needed. Then number three, polyethylene terephthalate, for short PET and PETG. So the PETG is the more used filament material, and G stands for glycol modified. That results in a PET material in a filament which is clearer, which is less brittle and easier to print compared to the regular PET. The PETG is a good place between ABS and the PLA, flexible and durable than the PLA and easier to print than the ABS. When to use it, PETG is again an all-rounder material, so you can also realize functional objects, functional application with it, such as mechanical parts, also protective components. So what is easy to print, flexible and durable. What are the cons? So it's hygroscopic. That means it absorbs moisture from the air. So you have to take proper care when you during printing. It's also sticky and it can be easily scratched. So ABS, it's much more scratch resistant, patchy not. Number four, thermoplastic elastomers, TPE. So TPE is a broad class of copolymers. It's a soft and stretchable material and not always easy to be extruded. And a part of the thermoplastic elastomers, we have also the thermoplastic urethanes, polyurethanes, TPUs. They're more rigid, that means they're easier to print. We have also a good elasticity at low temperatures. So at low temperature, the TPU is more suitable. When to use? So applications that are bended, stretched or compressed. So this can be from toys over wearables. You can also, for example, shoes, a good candidate TPEs to use there. What are the pros? Extremely flexible. So you can do multiple bending and stretching without problems. Cons, it's the printing itself, it's much slower, it is more difficult to print, and you need really have a precise tight filament path. Then number five, polyamides, PA, or also known as nylons. So the polyamide filaments, they have really the strength, flexibility and durability. You can also color them with dyes. So either before or after printing, and most use filaments 618 and 645. When to use now polyamide? So always when you need application which should work as functional prototype, also tools and mechanical parts. Mechanical parts like hinges, buckles or gears. So you see, this is a really always this functional applications. The pros are the high durability, the high strength, high flexibility. The cons are polyamide is a hygroscopic material, so it seeks moisture from the air. Again, proper storage and also dry the material. It is more expensive compared to the other before mentioned materials. We also need here a high nozzle and print bed temperature. Number six of the big six, polycarbonate, PC. So PC is really a perfect filament for applications which are exposed to heat to 110 degrees C. This material can be used. It is transparent. And when you compare it to acrylic or plexiglass, it is not cracking under stress, so this is a major advantage compared to plexiglass. When to use polycarbonate? So when you have application which need strength, toughness and keep the shapes in high temperature environments. Also, when you need applications which need to be transparent. Pros, resistant to heat and physical impact, and it's a strong, tough material. Cons, compared also to polyamide, is also hygroscopic, and you need also high printing temperatures. Okay, let's have a look at the high performance polymer filaments. So on the one hand, we have polyether ether ketone, so PEEK or polyether ketone ketone. This is really a high heat filament, so up to 240 C and chem. So it's really suitable for metal replacement and also for oil and gas applications, applications in aerospace, aircraft and also automotive. Then there's polyphenylsulfone, PPSU. It's a material which has outstanding toughness, so polycarbonate is already tough, however the PPSU is even tougher. Here we have also flame resistance, so we have V0 levels of flame resistance, temperature resistance, and also hydrolytics that are suitable for healthcare applications, smart devices, and also applications of space field. It is also a semi-transparent filament. Also like polyethylamide, so the third one mentioned here, it's also semi-transparent, so it's more golden looking. It has also high heat resistance up to 200 degrees C and also high impact behavior, and all of those materials need extreme temperatures, so we talk always about 350 to 307 degrees C. Want to have more information on polymer engineering topics, I highly recommend you my blog, find out about plastics.com. As well, in the field of polymer material selection, I offer online courses, general polymer material selection, and also in polymer material selection for electrical vehicles. I will link you both the blog and the online courses in the description below. Okay. Thank you for watching, and do not forget to subscribe and smash that like button. Till next time, and bye.